Good afternoon. I'm Joseph Garrison, the Minister of Music and Worship here at Pine Street and the Artistic Director for MAPS Music at Pine Street. On behalf of our staff, our congregation, and the American Guild of Organists, welcome to today's concert. Just a little housekeeping. If you parked in the South Street garage, you will need a chaser ticket in order to exit without charge. Our ushers have those tickets, and they'll be happy to share those with you after the concert. If you would like to contribute to the financial success of these concerts and future concerts, there's offering plates at the exit, so we hope you'll give generously. Today's, of course, will be split between the American Guild of Organists and Music at Pine Street. He is described as indomitable and immensely gifted, an artist of rare sensitivity and passion, known for his creative and unique abilities in organ improvisation, and named a semi-finalist in the 2005 St. Albans International Organ Festival Improvisation Competition, the only American to merit that distinction. He is the organist and choir master at St. Mark's Episcopal Church in Philadelphia. You can find his full bio in the program. I must apologize, the QR code on the back that gives the specifications for the organ. I don't know what happened. I always check those codes, and I even went upstairs and reloaded the correct file, but it is not updating. So if you look at that, you'll find a service here from March. I don't know how that happened. I'm quite certain it's not my fault. Ladies and gentlemen, we're thankful you're here today. Please help me welcome Robert McCormick.
If you couldn't, I'll see if I can turn it up a little more for those of you in the back. I will say that after I registered the program on this magnificent organ, the other day I went downstairs, and it's so wonderful to hear the organ down there. It works so beautifully in the space, which is one of the many reasons it's a great privilege and pleasure to have the honor of being with you here to make music in person with actual people present. What a joy and privilege that is, and all the more so in this beautiful church with this magnificent organ, thanks to the kind hospitality of Pine Street, of Joseph, and of the AGO, particularly Tyler Canonico, the sub-dean. So I thank them for their welcome. I played a recital here at Pine Street Presbyterian, I think almost exactly 15 years ago. And I suppose that everyone who was there at the time has forgotten about it, so it was safe to invite me back. There are several common themes or threads running through the program today, which admittedly is a little bit unusual in some respects. The repertoire is all French or American. If you're an organist, you will of course note that Jean Langlais and Maurice Durufle are the French composers. The rest are American. The Americans, several of them lived and worked in New York City during a great time in the music making in that city from the 70s through the early aughts. And that was Calvin Hampton, David Hurd, McNeil Robinson, and Jerry Hancock. Thankfully, David Hurd is still very much with us. Another common theme is that all the pieces except for one are on hymn tunes. The Gregorian Te Deum, a great plain song hymn of praise of the church, we praise thee, O God. And then the four that I'm about to play next, all by American composers. Engelberg, which is an English tune, but given your treatment by Calvin Hampton, is often sung to All Praise to Thee, for Thou, O King Divine, or When in Our Music God is Glorified. Wondrous Love, a great American shape note tune, here in a meditation, a fantasy on that tune. Lawnfare, a Welsh tune, most commonly associated with Ascension Day, is given a wistful and somewhat melancholy setting by McNeil Robinson. And I should have mentioned that Mary Beth Bennett is very much still with us as well. She lives and works in Richmond and is a multi-talented composer, organist, and teacher. And Kingsfold is an English folk tune, which she gives a wild and exotic setting of in her piece. I hope you enjoy them very much. The next piece, another organ variation, a set of organ variations on a hymn, another Gregorian chant hymn, especially appropriate for this day of Pentecost. Maurice Stewart plays chorale variae, or chorale variations, on the Veni Creator. These variations are the final section of his larger prelude adagio and chorale variae, and so I'm just playing those final variations. If I played the whole thing today, I fear that you would all really get very tired of me. But they use different colors of the organ. There's a statement of the chorale theme to begin, and then three variations of different characters, and then sort of a toccata to conclude. Dan Locklear is another living American composer. His rubrics is an organ suite in five movements. Rubrics is a word that means instructions in a prayer book. They're called rubrics because of the color red, and in older prayer books and in some modern prayer books, the instructions are still printed in red. So there are five rubrics that he excerpted from the Episcopal Book of Common Prayer from 1979. And this one, "The Peace Shall Be May Be Exchanged," is something that most churches have not been doing a lot of during COVID, so you can at least imagine it. Finally, the final composed piece on the program is Jerry Hancock's Prelude and Fugue on Union Seminary. Union Seminary is the hymn tune name for the hymn "Draw Us in the Spirit's Tether," which is better known, really, in its choral anthem form. "Draw Us in the Spirit's Tether," a tune by the composer Harold Friedel. And then after that, Mr. Canonico has a surprise for me, I believe. Thank you.
Thank you.
So the way this works is I've not seen these themes, and I don't know what they are. And there's even a note that says, do not open until the end of the program. So I'll open the envelope, and I will play just a little bit of each one, and so we can learn them together. I learned to read music just for this moment.